Dear students, today we are going to the next chapter, selfless service. Okay, here they are giving a best example for the selfless service is the life of Mother Teresa. Chapter 12. God has bestowed us with many blessings, beautiful nature, loving and caring parents, friends, elders, teachers, etc. Okay, the God have given us many blessings. Our beautiful nature, our loving parents and friends, elders and our teachers. We must thank Him for all these gifts. In our life, we must thank Him for all these gifts. And how do you show that you love God and thankful to Him for all that He has given you? The best way they are giving how we can show our love to God and thankful to Him for He given us the lot of blessings. There are some people that they are showing their love for praying, their love by praying to God. And some people visit holy places regularly. That's the way they are showing their love. But the best way to show Him our love is to love our fellow beings. Okay, fellow beings means our colleagues, our fellow beings, our society. There are a lot of people. We should love our fellow beings. One such person was Mother Teresa. She was a great soul whose heart was full of compassion for the poor and needy people. Actually, the best compassionate person is Mother Teresa. Okay. One such person was Mother Teresa. And she also had a great soul. And her heart was full of compassion for all the poor and needy people. In our society, there are a lot of poor and needy people are there, and she have a compassion for them. Her selfless service among us, the destitute and deceased, is a story of courage and sacrifice. Actually, she giving a selfless service. Selfless service means service without expecting anything. Okay. And Mother Teresa was born in Yugoslavia. She became a nun at the age of 16. When she was 18 years old, she was sent to a convent in Kolkata. Actually, she was born in Yugoslavia and she became a nun at the age of 16. And she was 18 years old at that time. She went to convent in Kolkata. Her convent was near the slum colony called Motijhel. She noticed that the children of that area were poor and ill-fed and sickly. Okay, actually her convent was near the slum colony. That colony name is Motijhel, and she has noticed that the children of that area were poor and ill-fed. They are very ill-fed and sickly. They are also sick people. She started to going that slum regularly, giving food every day. She is started to going to that slum colony and giving food, medicines and care. This is the most important thing for giving the food, medicine and care. Seeing this misery and poverty of the slum, she decided to start a separate institution of dedicated workers who would help her to serve humanity. Okay, this she is seeing the misery. After seeing this poverty and of the slum, she decided to start a new institution. It's a separate institution of the dedicated workers who would help her to service humanity. Those who are interested in to service humanity and self-service dedicators, for them she start a new separate institution. She called this institution Missionaries of Charity. The name of the institution is Missionaries of Charity. She gathered large donations and established the Nirmal Hriday Home for the physically challenged people near Damdam Airport in Kolkata. In Damdam Airport in Kolkata, near that, too much people are physically challenged, and she gathered large donations for establishing the Nirmal Hriday Home. That home is for physically challenged people. She brought cheer into the lives of poor children. She used to say, all life is sacred. All are God's children and have the rights to get love and care. She brought cheer into lives of poor children.
Okay, her ambition is to give cheer into lives of poor children. She used to say, she is saying that all life is sacred. All the life is sacred. All are God's children and have the right to get love and care.
Okay, they all have the right to get love and care. Mother Teresa started her work with the only four sisters, and today more than 2,000 sisters belong to her order take care of the needy in orphans, dispensaries and schools. Okay, firstly, there are only four sisters.
Now, today, 2,000 sisters are doing her work for the society.
And Mother Teresa was awarded the Nobel Prize in 1979. She was also awarded the Bharat Ratna Award. The highest national award of India is Bharat Ratna. She awarded that. And her life is an example for the new generation. So we must also try to follow her footsteps and help the physically challenged and needy people. Okay. Today the chapter is over. We must get inspiration from Mother Teresa's life. Okay, she is the best service woman. Okay,
she didn't expect anything from anyone.
Only self-service is her ambition. Okay.